You can see the screen, right? Can you see the screen?
सर
ओके सो ओके सो एज आई सेड वी कैन मूव टू अ प्रॉब्लम टू अप्लाई द इक्वेशंस व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड फॉर द लास्ट सेशंस. It's a simply simple problem that we want. We don't need the data for this calculation. We are just using the equations for applications. So there are few problems out there which you don't want to refer the data book for the beginners. Okay. So let us move to the problem. Please write down. Take your notebook. An Aerojet question is. An Aerojet at 400 Kelvin, at 400 Kelvin has sonic velocity, has sonic velocity. An Aerojet at 400 Kelvin has sonic velocity. That is the question. Then determine. Determine first one velocity of sound at 400 Kelvin. Velocity of sound at 400 Kelvin. Second question, velocity of sound at stagnation condition. Velocity of sound at stagnation condition. Third question, maximum velocity of jet. Maximum velocity of jet. And last one, stagnation enthalpy. Stagnation enthalpy. Okay, so this is the question. It says that an air jet at 400 Kelvin has sonic velocity. That is our condition. Then you want to find the velocity of sound A at 400 Kelvin. Velocity of sound is stagnation condition A naught. Maximum velocity of fluid C max. And stagnation enthalpy H naught. These are the values you want to find out. Okay. So moving to the condition. Condition is very important. The problem is very important. The condition. So it says that it says that an Aerojet has a sonic velocity, right? It has a sonic velocity. Sonic velocity means, what is the condition for a sonic velocity? What is the condition for a sonic condition?
M is equal to 1.
M equal to 1, yes, very good. M is equal to 1. So at sonic velocity, M equal to 1, that is Mach number equal to 1, that is C equal to A. C equal to A, that is the condition. Then it is given that an air jet, air, or one on air. So we can take the value of gamma as 1.4. So as I said, 90% of your problem in CFF is dealing with the air. And the gamma is taking as 1.4. If it is not given, you can take it as 1.4. The air, standard value for gamma for air is 1.4. If there is any other problem, it is 1.3. So, if 90% of your problem dealing with gamma 1.4, so it is not given in a problem, but you can take the value as 1.4 because it is the air. Gamma equal to 1.4. And temperature is also given. Yes, 400 Kelvin. 400 Kelvin. That is our conditions. So, in velocity, gamma 1.4, T equal to 400 Kelvin. So, first one, what is the first question? Velocity of sound at 400 Kelvin. It's a very, very, very simple problem. Just you want to apply the equation only. First question is to find the value for velocity of sound. What is the symbol for velocity of sound?
A.
A. A equal to, what is the equation?
Root of gamma into R naught.
Yes, very, very good. Root of gamma RT. It is the equation for velocity of sound. So, gamma value is given, temperature is given, R value, it will be given or not given. So it is an air condition. Air, you can take the value of R as 287. 287 joule per kilogram Kelvin. So there are standard values for air, gamma equal 1.4, R equal 287 joule per kilogram Kelvin. Mark this is very important and make it in a box. You want to take that equation value for a whole modules. Okay, then just substitute the value only. Root 1.4 into 287 into temperature 400. But I had a mic on it. Okay, there's a disturbance here. A equal to root gamma RT 1.4 into 287 into 400 Kelvin. Just substitute the value, you will get the value in meter per second. A equal to 1.4 into 287 into 400 root of. You will get the value as 400.899 meter per second. 400.899 meter per second as first question, A equal to root gamma T naught. So gamma T. Okay, that is our first question. So moving to the next one, velocity of sound is stagnation condition. Velocity of sound is stagnation condition equation is A naught equal to root gamma R T naught, right? Root gamma R T naught. So A naught equal to root gamma R T naught. This is the stagnation velocity of sound. So here gamma is given, R is given, but T naught is not given. T naught is not given in your problem. So you want to find the T naught value first. So to find the value of T naught, you have the equation. You have the equation for T naught, the stagnation temperature. There the equation. The equation for stagnation temperature, you have already written that T naught by T equal to T naught by T equal to T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 in m square. What is it? 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 in m square. So last class we had error the equation for stagnation condition. T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 in m square. Okay. Here it is. T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 into m square. Stagnation temperature. So here, T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 into m square. Therefore, T naught equal to the right? Gets T is given, T temperature is given, gamma is given, and m. What is m here? M equal to 1. Sonic velocity, m equal to 1. So you can find the value of T naught. So this type of problem will be asking your university question. So if it is a lengthy problem or a small problem, just you want to take this type of equation only, A naught, T naught by T, that particular equations for H naught, C max, etc. That is the value you want to take. So T naught by T equal to 1 plus 1.4 minus 1 by 2 into M. M is 1, 1 square is equal to 1. So you can give that. So 1 plus 1.4 minus 1 by 2. And then into T and T naught into T. So here you can cross multiply this value 1.4 plus 1 by 2, 2.4 by 2. 2.4 by 2 into 400. 2.4 by 2 is 1.2. 1.2 into 400. Okay, that is 480 Kelvin. 1.2 divided by 2, that is 480 Kelvin into 400 is 480 Kelvin. This T naught value, stagnation temperature. When you find the value of stagnation temperature, just apply that value in our equation to find A naught. Therefore, A naught equal to root 1.4 into 287 into 480. You will get A naught value in meter per second. 1.4 into 287 into 480. 1.4 into 287 into 480, that is 439.16 meter per second. 439.16 meter per second is the value for A naught, stagnation velocity of sound. Okay. Then third question. You want to find the value for Cmax, maximum velocity of sound. Maximum velocity of sound. So what is the equation for maximum velocity of sound? We have already discussed about what is maximum velocity and the KI equation. So in the previous session, you have studied that maximum velocity is given. C max equal to root 2 H naught is our first equation. C max equal to root 2 H naught. But here H naught is not given in your problem. So you can't take this equation here. You can't take this equation because C max equal to root into H naught. H naught is not given. C max and H naught is unknown value. So you can't take this equation. So next equation is C max equal to A naught into root 2 by gamma minus 1. This is the C max equal to A naught into root 2 by gamma minus 1. That is an equation. C max equal to root A naught into. So you can take this equation. A naught is given. A naught, you already find the value for A naught, gamma is given. So C max equal to A naught into root 2 by gamma minus 1. Third question. C max equal to A naught into root 2 by gamma minus 1. That is 439.16 into root 2 by 1.4 minus 1. Just substitute and calculate. Use your calculator wisely and speedily. Just find out the value by substituting the suitable equation. Suitable values for suitable A naught, C max, H naught, T naught, A, C, M, etc., etc. That is only method you want to follow to do the problems. So here C max value can be found out by using this equation. You can't use the equation that root 2 H naught because H naught value is not given. So here you can find the value of C max directly from here is 439.16 into root of 2 by 1.4 minus 1 is 2 by 0.4. And the value for C max is given as 982 meter per second. 982 meter per second. 982 meter per second. Then fourth question and the last question is to find out the stagnation enthalpy H naught. Stagnation enthalpy H naught. So what is the equation for H naught, stagnation enthalpy? H naught. There is an equation for H naught, but you already know the value. C max and equation we put in there. It come but two lah. No one equation. That is C max equal to root 2 H naught. So you can use this equation itself because C max is already find out. Only 2 is the remaining, this constant value. So you can find the value directly from here. This relation. C max equal to root 2 H naught. That is C square max equal to 2 H naught. Sorry. 2 H naught. We can remove the root by squaring the C max. Then H naught equal to C square max divided by 2. C square max divided by 2. C square max is 982. 982 square divided by 2 is the H naught value. 982 square divided by 2 is the H naught value. Okay. By this week, we can complete this module. But before that, you want to do some problems using a data book. So bring your or buy your data book, very compulsory. It's very compulsory to buy your data book. We can't do more problems without using data book. So 90 square by 2 is 482. 482.16 kilojoule per kilogram. 482.16 kilojoule per kilogram is the value for H naught static enthalpy. Okay, this is our problem. So in this problem, you find four terms, that is velocity of sound, stagnation condition, maximum velocity, stagnation RP. So four questions are four equations. But we can relate one to another by using the relations equations that you have studied in the last previous sessions. So please, a question, before attempting a question, just read the question very carefully. A one or two hints will be there in your problem itself. So in this problem, it is given as air jet. Air jet means gamma 1.4 and R287. This is the first hint. Second hint is sonic velocity. Sonic velocity means C equal to A or M equal to 1. M equal to 1 is the second hint in the problem. So in the a small word air jet has four hints. A single line have a two hints to do the problem. If you understood the problem very carefully, very clearly, you can do the problem very wisely. Okay. So that is all about the problem. So moving on to the next topic. That is wave propagation. Wave propagation means, so you have already studied about fluids, because liquid and gas, movements of liquid and gas. As I said, compressible fluid flow is the study of the fluid flow. So here wave propagation means, wave propagation is a topic other than the flow of liquid. This it deals with the movement of waves. Movement of waves when a force acting on a particular body. So for example is, when we throw a stone to the to a pond or river, a wave formation is there, and the wave is moving to the nearer to farer as like a circle, right? So it is a wave propagation, movement of wave. So here we are studying the equation for velocity of sound, velocity of the particular thing, and when the force is applied and the wave movement of the wave. We are studying the analysis of the wave movement on a body. When a force is applied to a particular body, elastic body. So elastic body, we have to pressure the wave formation movement. Okay. So first of all, take an elastic body, a rectangular piece of body with a cross-section A. When we apply a particular force here, F, a compressive force, F, in Newton per meter square, there is a wave formation in the particular body. And let us take that a wave formation here. It is given as like this, wave front. You can, wave front is wave in the umbo, wave front. You can take a wave front, formation of wave by the application of force from one side to another. There is a pressure applied. Then the whole length of this section is given as, we can take it as a length L. Whole section is can be taken as length L. Okay. The distance traveled by the wave front. So when a force applied here, the wave formed here, it is traveled from this, like this, from So when a time t, the movement of wave from this portion to this portion is given as AT. That is movement of the distance traveled by the wave by the action of force at a time t. Okay. movement of the wave when a force is applied F at a time t is given as at. And then when the force applied on chirungu body, like, then the full length will be reduced by a small, very particular, very small area. That when a compressive force is applied to elastic body, compressive force is applied to elastic body, when we press our erasing rubber at once, the area or the length of the rubber get reduced when we are pressing, like it is an elastic body. So as like that, when we are applying a force from one side, the length of the particular component, length L, will be reduced by a small component that is given as delta L. Small area that reduces delta L. So this is a figure, the analysis of the wave formation, that is when a force is applied to a, from a one side, a wave is formed, and wave that is moved from one portion to another at a distance, this A, at a time t, it is given as AT. Cross section of this body is A, length of the body is L, and the small distance, compressible distance, can be taken as delta L. Delta L. Then the change in the length of the, this taken as delta L. Therefore, strain can be explained as the strain formed here. Strain means a wave in the mother. And the strain of the particular wave front moved here, it is taken as strain means change in length, delta L. This is the waveform distance. AT is the distance here, not L. Wave in the mother, AT is the distance of the wave traveled. And the fall distance can be taken as AT of wave itself, not body, wave, AT. So the distance reduced is delta L divided by AT. Strain of the wave formed, not strain of the body, whole body, strain of the wave formed is delta L divided by AT. That is change in length by original length, change in length divided by full length, delta L by AT. Then modulus of velocity E can be defined as stress by strain. Modulus of velocity E can be defined as stress by strain. Okay. Stress by strain is the modulus of velocity, as we all know. Then here stress is F, when we have the force applied, stress F. F divided by delta L by AT. Stress by strain is F divided by delta by AT. Delta L by AT. The equation for E is F divided by delta L by AT. Okay, that is the first condition. First condition. Then the particle velocity of the medium. The velocity of the medium can be taken as, or the velocity of the movement of the wave can be defined as C equal to, velocity of movement of the wave can be defined as C equal to length by time, distance traveled by time is velocity, distance by time is speed, but displacement by time is velocity. Can take change in length, this is the distance traveled divided by time as velocity. Change in length is delta L divided by time t. This is divided by time, you can take as velocity. Then t can be substituted from here. Okay, delta L by T, delta L by T. So here there is a delta L by T here. Delta L by T is written, that is E equal to F by delta L by AT is here. From here we can take the equation for delta L by T. Delta L by T is F by EA. F by E by A. That is, when delta L by T goes here, E comes down, then E by A is the delta L by T is here. Okay. Delta L by T move here and E comes down. Delta L by T. Then F by E by A is the equation for delta L by T. F by E by A is the equation remaining for delta L by T. So substitute for delta L by T as from one, put this equation as one. From one, we can say that C is also equal to E divided by F by A. Sorry, F divided by E by A. F divided by E by A. So you got the two equations here. First equation is the second equation. Second equation, C equal to F divided by E by A. Then second state, that is applying momentum equation to the system. Applying momentum equation to the system. Momentum equation means impulsive force equal to change in momentum. That is the momentum equation. First one, there are three derivation. First one is momentum equation for conservation of mass, conservation of momentum, and conservation of energy. From that conservation of momentum, you will get the equation that impulsive force equal to change in momentum. Impulsive force equal to change in momentum. From second law of thermodynamics says that you have studied the change in momentum equation as mass into velocity, like MV. Impulsive force is force into distance. Force into distance traveled. Force into distance traveled. Impulsive force is sudden force applied. Impulsive force equal to change in momentum MV. Momentum equation. So applying this some distance this equation here, you will get another equation for C. C equal to equation under command. What are you Then F into distance traveled can be taken as AT. AT is the distance traveled by the that wavefront equal to mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. Velocity here we can have C, not V, C. Therefore M density equal to mass by volume. From therefore mass equal to density into volume. Mass equal to density into volume. Volume is area into height. Density area into height. Area into distance traveled by the front. Area into AT. Height means area on a cross sectional area. Area into distance traveled AT here. So mass can be written as, for mass we can substitute as density into A into AT. Density into A into AT into C. Density into A into AT into C. Then here AT and AT get cancelled. And you will get another equation for C. It is F by rho into A. F into rho into A. Into it. Okay. Down C equal to F in by rho in dV. So you get the two equations from here for C. First one is E F by E by A. And second one is C equal to F by rho in dV. F by rho in dV. Then equate the two equations 2 and 3. Equate the two equations 2 and 3. And you will get an equation for A equal to so complete that equation by equating the two equations. Equate the two equations, see 2 equal to 3, then find as an equation. Take this work as a homework and please go through the problem that you had discussed in the session and study the equations, equations that you want to study very compulsory for A naught, H naught, T naught by T. I think the whole equation it is there in the data book itself. So just buy the data book, that is steam tables for compressible flow problems and look after the problem. That's all about this session.